We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men and women, boys and girls are created equal. I have a dream that the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will one day be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. Spokane, I have a dream. I have a dream that even in the state of Mississippi, a state that is sweltering with the heat of oppression, sweltering with the heat of injustice, will one day be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four children, Bernice and Yolanda, Dexter, Martin Luther King III, the Obamas, will live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content and beauty of their character. I got a dream. I have a dream that down there in Alabama, with his vicious races, with his governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, down there in Alabama, little black boys and little black girls will be able to hold hands with little white boys and little white girls as sisters and brothers. Spokane, I have a dream. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places shall be made plain, the crooked places shall be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the South with. With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, play together, pray together, struggle together, go to jail together, stand up for freedom together, knowing that one day, we shall be free. And this will be the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with new meaning, "My country." Y'all don't hear this.
Woo, come on.
"My country, 'tis of thee."
Yes.
"Sweet land of liberty."
Oh yeah.
"Of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of thy pilgrim pride, from every mountain side, let freedom ring." And Spokane, if America is to be a great nation, then this must be so. So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from Trump Tower in Manhattan. Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of California. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi, from